Dear learners, welcome to NIOS. Today we will discuss about some common diseases. It's a part of your senior secondary course. Let me introduce myself to you. I am Dr. Sonali Singh. Now we come on to diseases. What are diseases? It's a sort of malfunctioning process which interferes with the normal functioning of the body. It's a type of disorder in the physical, physiological, psychological or social state of a person that is caused due to nutritional deficiency, physiological disorder, genetic disorder, pathogen or any other kind of reason. Now we come on to the types of diseases. These are basically classified into two main categories. First is congenital disease and the second one is acquired disease. Acquired diseases are further divided into two parts, communicable disease and non-communicable diseases. These non-communicable diseases are further divided into more parts. The first one is degenerative disease, deficiency disease, allergies, cancer, and other specific diseases. Now, first, I would like to tell you what is the difference between communicable and non-communicable diseases. Your communicable diseases are caused by some biological agents or pathogens such as viruses, bacteria, protozoans and helminthes and spread from one person to the other through contact of water, air and food, etc. Non-communicable diseases are caused due to some specific factors such as malfunctioning of some vital organ and deficiency of nutrition. Well clear that they do not spread from one person to the other. Now we come on to the modes of spread of communicable diseases. There are several ways by which they spread out. First is your direct transmission. Direct, as the word clearly indicates, means that is direct contact between the infected person and the healthy person. Examples of these kind of diseases are smallpox, chickenpox, syphilis, gonorrhea, droplet infection. Example, common cold, pneumonia, influenza, measles, tuberculosis. And when there is contact with soil contaminated disease causing viruses and bacteria. It can also occur through animal bite. Now we come on to the indirect transmissions. These include by vectors such as house flies, mosquitoes and cockroaches. Very common examples are malaria, as you are well aware of, dengue, etc. Then you have airborne diseases, example is typhus. You have object-borne diseases, that is fungi-borne, and water-borne diseases, example cholera, diarrhea, hepatitis or jaundice. Now we will discuss all these diseases one by one in detail. What are their pathogens? What is the mode of transmission of these diseases? What are the symptoms that show that these diseases are going to occur in your body? First one which we will discuss is chickenpox. Its pathogen is chickenpox virus and that is called varicella. Its mode of transmission happens through scabs and your incubation period varies from 12 to 20 days. Symptoms are fever, headache, loss of appetite and dark red colored rashes on the back and chest of the body, as very clearly visible through the photograph. You can prevent it through a vaccine, that is Varilrix. The patient should be kept in isolation and its clothing and utensils used by the patient should be sterilized and fallen scraps should be collected and burnt. The second disease that we are going to discuss is measles. It is caused by a virus, rubella, and its mode of transmission mainly occurs by air. Its incubation period varies from 3 to 5 days and there are several symptoms as common cold, appearance of small white patches in mouth and throat, appearances of rashes and body. Now we come on to the prevention and cure of this disease. Obviously, the patient has to be kept in isolation and cleanliness should be maintained. Antibiotics should be given to the patient. Another deadly disease that occurs, that is that we Indians are facing, is poliomyelitis, polio commonly known as. Its pathogen is poliovirus. Its incubation period varies from 7 to 14 days. Symptoms shows that it clearly it's the virus multiplies in intestinal cells and then reaches the brain through blood. It damages brains and nerves and causes infantile paralysis. How you can prevent it? What is the prevention for it? Polio vaccine drops, that is oral polio vaccine, should be given to children at certain regular intervals. Pulse polio program is always organized in our country to give this polio vaccine to our children. we are going to discuss is rabies. It is also called as hydrophobia. Its pathogen is rabies virus, and it happens by a bite by a rabid dog. Symptoms: severe headache, high fever, painful contraction of muscles of throat and chest, choking, and fear of water leading to death. Now, what are its prevention and cure? Compulsory immunization of dogs should be done, killing of rabid-based animals, anti-rabies injection should be given to the patient. The next disease which we are going to discuss is hepatitis. Its pathogen is hepatitis B virus. Mode of transmission, it mainly occurs through contaminated water, and its incubation period is very long, varying from 15 to 160 days. Symptoms: you have body ache, you have loss of appetite and nausea, eyes and skin become yellowish, urine deep yellow in color, enlarged liver. How do we prevent it? So the first thing that we need to get is vaccine, which is also available in our country. Proper hygiene has to be observed, and we have to take very simple food during this disease. The next disease that is that we are going to discuss is influenza. It is caused by a virus which attacks our body cells, resulting in various effects depending on the strain of virus. It clearly shows the symptoms of high fever in adults, respiratory tract infection symptoms such as cough, sore throat, running nose, headache, pain in the muscles, and extreme fatigue. How can you control it? Much of the illness and death caused by influenza can be prevented by annual influenza vaccine. The person suffering from influenza should drink plenty of fluids, take relief with paracetamol, aspirin, not in the children under the age of 16, or ibuprofen as a painkiller is being suggested to it. The next disease which we will discuss now is dengue. Dengue is an acute fever caused by a virus. It is of two types: dengue fever normal and dengue hemorrhagic fever. It spreads through the bite of an infected Aedes aegypti mosquito. Its incubation period is 4 to 6 days, and you can diagnose it with help of blood tests. Now, what are its symptoms? Sudden onset of high fever, generally 104 to 100 degree Fahrenheit, which may last up to 45 days, severe headache, pain in the joints and muscles, body aches, pain behind the eyes, nausea, vomiting, etc. Now, what are the symptoms of dengue hemorrhagic fever? Severe and continuous pain in the abdomen, rashes on the skin. It even results the bleeding from the nose, mouth, or the internal organs, frequent vomiting with or without blood, black stools due to internal bleeding, and excessive thirst. This is a very deadly disease, and you need to consult the doctor immediately once the person is diagnosed by dengue. Now, we come on to the diseases that are caused by bacteria. The first one which we will discuss is tuberculosis. Its pathogen is bacterium, Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Mode of transmission is airborne, discharge through sputum, cough, sneeze of the infected person. And its incubation period varies from 2 to 10 weeks. Symptoms, again, persistent fever, coughing, chest pain, blood comes out with sputum, weakness. How can you prevent it now? We need to isolate the person who is suffering, and BCG vaccination should be given to the children as a preventive measure. Now we come on to another bacteria caused disease, that is typhoid. Its pathogen is called as Salmonella typhi. It's a bacillus rod shaped bacterium. Now, what is the mode of transmission? It occurs through contaminated food and water, and its incubation period varies from 1 to 3 weeks. The symptoms are clearly continuous fever, headache, slow pulse rate, reddish rashes appear on the belly. Even in the extreme cases, ulcers may rupture, resulting in death of the patient. Now, how can we prevent it? First of all, we need to give anti-typhoid inoculation to the patient. We need to avoid all those junk and exposed food and drinks that is prepared in unhygienic conditions. We also need to maintain proper sanitation and cleanliness, and we need to properly dispose the excreta of the patient. Antibiotics should be administered properly at regular intervals from time to time. The third disease that we are going to discuss now is cholera. It's caused by a coma-shaped bacterium, Vibrio cholerae. The mode of transmission is contaminated food and water. Again, housefly becomes one of the most vital carrier of this kind of disease. Incubation period varies from 6 hours to 2 to 3 days. Symptoms are clearly visible in the body. The patient starts showing acute diarrhea conditions and watery stool. Muscular cramps occur in the body. Loss of minerals through urine and dehydration even leads to the death of the patient. Now, how do we need to cure it? First of all, cholera vaccination should be given to the patient. We need to check out the dehydration content that is occurring in the patient. Plus, we need proper washing and cooking of food. Raw food should not be given to the patient. Properly cooked food should be given to the patient. And we need the proper disposal of vomit and human excreta. Fly should not be allowed to sit on eatables and utensils. Proper sanitation has to be maintained. The next disease which we will discuss is diphtheria. It is caused by pathogen which is rod-shaped bacterium, that is Cornibacterium diphtheriae. The mode of transmission is through air or droplet infection. Its incubation period varies from 2 to 4 days. Symptoms are clearly visible in the patient, that is a patient starts suffering from slight fever, sore throat and general indisposition. Oozing semi-solid material in the throat which develops into a tough membrane. The membrane may cause clogging or it means that it can block your air passage resulting into death. Now how do we need to prevent it? Immediate medical attention should be given to the patient. Baby should be given a DPT vaccine. Sputum, oral and nasal discharges of the infected child should be disposed of. Antibiotics may be given under doctor's supervision at regular intervals. And we need to isolate the infected child. The next disease which we are going to discuss is leprosy. It's also a bacteria-borne disease, and the bacteria responsible to cause this disease is Mycobacterium leprae. The mode of transmission is prolonged contact with the infected person. Nasal secretions are the most likely infectious material for family contacts. Its incubation period varies from 1 to 5 years. The symptoms are it affects your skin, formation of nodules and ulcer, scabs and deformities of fingers and toes, infected area loose sensation. From the picture, it's very clear that how deadly disease is this. Now we will discuss some diseases that are caused by protozoans. And the first disease that is caused by protozoan is malaria, one of the dreadful diseases in where our children get highly affected by this disease. The pathogen is malarial parasite. These are the different species of Plasmodium. The mode of transmission is by bite of female Anopheles mosquitoes. Incubation period is round about roughly 12 days. Now, the symptoms that are clearly visible in the patient is headache, nausea, and muscular pain. Feeling of chilliness and shivering followed by fever which becomes normal along with sweating after some time. The patient becomes very weak and anemic, and if not treated properly, secondary complications may lead even to death. Now, how can we prevent? What is the curation for this type of disease? The first is you need to prevent the mosquitoes entry to your houses. You need to use mosquito net and mosquito repellents. No water should be allowed to collect in ditches or other open spaces to prevent mosquito breeding. The next we will discuss is amoebiasis. Or it is commonly called as amoebic dysentery. The pathogen responsible to this disease is Entamoeba histolytica. Now, what are the modes of transmission of disease? Again, the contaminated food and water. Learners, we are seeing that so many diseases are being caused by the contaminated food and water. So, we need to take care of all these things. Now, what are the symptoms for these diseases? First is it results in the formation of ulcers in intestine, feeling of abdominal pain and nausea, acute diarrhea and mucus in stool. Proper sanitation should be maintained to avoid it. Now, we will discuss the disease caused by worms, that is helminthes. The first one is filariasis. The pathogen is filarial worm. Mode of transmission, it is bites of mosquitoes, Aedes and Culex. It results in high fever, collection of endothelial cells and metabolites in the wall of lymph vessels. Swelling takes place in certain parts of the body like legs, breast and scrotum. swelling of legs which appears as legs of elephant. So the disease is also called as elephantiasis. Now, how can we prevent this kind of diseases? Mesh doors and windows in the house to check the entry of mosquitoes. The water collected in tanks or other articles should be properly covered. Now we will discuss some non-communicable diseases, that is the diseases that cannot be spread transmitted from one person to the other person. The first disease that we are going to discuss is diabetes mellitus. This is a disease that can be diagnosed by blood test or urine test, and it causes less secretion of insulin hormone from the pancreas. It is also caused by mental stress. Even through heredity from parents to children, it is transferred. What are the symptoms of this disease? We have more glucose in blood, excessive and frequent passing of urine, feeling thirsty and hungry frequently, and reducing healing capacity of any sort of injury. We need to take a serious look on this disease, and it can be cured by several methods. First is, you need to control the excessive weight of the body. A regulated and controlled diet should be taken, and the food should not contain much of sugar and carbohydrates. As from the picture, it is very clear that chronic complications of diabetes results in severe diseases as blindness, kidney disease, nerve disease, and even the body parts could be amputated also. Now we come on to the cardiovascular diseases. This is a very, very common disease. I think most persons who are undergoing stress are suffering from this kind of disease. What are the main causes for this disease? Due to deposition of cholesterol, that is a kind of fat, in the walls of coronary arteries, which restrict the flow of blood to the heart muscles. This could lead to a heart attack. Due to reduced blood supply and reduced oxygen available to the muscles, heart's efficiency is affected. It also is caused due to stress and strain and obesity. The next one is your hypertension, that is high blood pressure. Few people are left who could be called very healthy, and everyone of is suffering from high blood pressure or any sort of this kind of disease. The symptoms are persistent high blood pressure. It may damage the arteries of kidney, and in extreme cases, the arteries may burst or blindness may be caused. Now, how can we prevent this disease? We should live in a very non-stressful environment. We should concentrate more on meditation, keeping our self cool, calm, peaceful and serene. Low fat diet should be taken. We should avoid oily food, cholesterol rich food, and weight of the body should be kept under control. The next disease that we are going to discuss is coronary heart disease. Now, what are the symptoms for this heart disease? You observe severe pain in the chest, gasping for breath. You cannot breathe properly. Intense nausea and vomiting starts, and lots of sweating takes place. Now, how can you prevent and cure this disease? A diet low in saturated fats should be taken. You should avoid the formation of cholesterol in your body. Sound eating habits should be developed. Avoid smoking, alcoholic drinks and drugs. Half an hour to 1 hour physical exercise must be a daily part of your routine. We should avoid sedentary lifestyle. The next disease which we are going to discuss is osteoporosis. It's an age-dependent disorder with loss of normal density of bone. It doesn't cause clear-cut symptoms, and one may not realize till your bone fractures out. Fractures of the spine can cause severe band-like pain that radiates around the from the back to the side of the body. Patients suffering from osteoporosis are generally treated with vitamin D and calcium supplements. Change of lifestyle and diet is highly recommended. Now you can see from the figure very clearly that what is the bone matrix of a normal person and how your bone matrix differ when you suffer from osteoporosis. The next deadly disease is again cancer, which we are even scared of listening, and it's now very frequently seen that when we hear that this person is suffering from the cancer or that lady is suffering from the cancer. It's uncontrolled and unwanted growth of cells. It is caused, there has been no definite reason for its causation. How do you develop it? The doctors have not been able to completely diagnose it. It is found that body has proto-oncogenes. These are activated by some substances or stimulus which convert these into active cancer-causing oncogenes. heavy smoking and alcoholism inflammates it, aggravates it. Chewing of tobacco also aggravates it. Consistent irritation of skin or repeated injury at the same point is also the reason for your cancer. Cancer is a kind of tumorous growth. Tumors can be classified basically into two categories, benign tumor and malignant tumor. Now, what are the symptoms of this? How they develop in our body? When you note any kind of persistent lump or thickening in tissues, especially in tongue, breast and uterus, it could be any irregular bleeding or blood-tinged discharge from any body opening. It is also caused by any sore that does not heal quickly. It is also formed when you notice the change in the form of your mole or wart. Treatment should be taken under medical supervision. From the picture, it is very clear the difference between the normal cells and when you develop cancer, then how our cells get deformed, how the shape changes of our cells. The next disease that we are going to discuss is allergy. And everyone of us is very familiar about this word allergy. Ki if we go out, I develop allergy due to strong permanent exposure when I stand in the sun. So these are some sorts of allergy that we develop in our body. It includes a group of non-infectious diseases. No definite cause is known when you develop any certain kind of allergy. It is believed that they occur due to hypersensitiveness of certain individuals to foreign matter that are called as allergens, which may enter inside our body. Symptoms could be sneezing, continuous sneezing, gasping, running of eyes, irritation of nose, itching, irritation of throat or trachea. Allergens may be, it could be pollen grain, feathers, some animals or insects, drugs, medicine, odor. When the weather changes, then also you develop a certain sort of allergy. Now we will discuss some sexually transmitted diseases. Diseases that are transmitted via the mucous membrane and secretions of the sexual organs, throat and rectum. Examples are syphilis, gonorrhea, AIDS. It's a very deadly disease and we all are very familiar of it. AIDS stands for Acquired Immunodeficiency Syndrome. It's a pandemic disease. It's a disease of cell-mediated immune system of the body. Now, what is a mode of transmission of AIDS? First of all, the sexual contact with the affected person results in AIDS. Using the same syringe that was used for the affected person can also cause us AIDS. Blood transfusion, which contains human immunodeficiency virus, plus organ transplantation of the affected person. Despite this, it can transfer from a mother to a newborn baby during the process of giving birth. Now, what are the symptoms of this disease? Nerves are severely affected. Brain is badly damaged with the loss of memory, ability to speak and even to think. The number of platelets become less, which may cause hemorrhage. It means that your thrombocytes disease can also occur. In severe cases, the patient shows swollen lymph nodes, fever and loss of weight. A full-blown disease at its peak may cause your death within 3 years. Now, how do we need to prevent it? There should not be any kind of sexual contact with a person who is already suffering from HIV infection. We need to use disposable syringe and needles. When any kind of blood transfusion is taking, please be very sure that all the hygienic and sanitation necessities were being maintained over there. Prostitution and homosexuality should be completely avoided. And we need to use some precautions as condoms during intercourse. Now, how can you control this deadly disease? We need to take the partner notification in this case, and plus education and screening for STD. AIDS can be detected by ELISA test. There are 3 points which may be important to control STD. You need to notify your partner, identification of potential infected contact, examination and treatment, and education of sexually transmitted diseases. It should be a part of general education. The next disease which we are going to discuss is syphilis. Its causative organism is Treponema pallidum. It spreads through sexual contact with the infected person. Again, symptoms occur in the body from about 9 to 2 days after contraction. fever and sores in the skin, in the throat and urogenital areas, especially vagina or penis, anus, rectum and mouth are visible. Rashes on hands, feet and palms occur, and there are white patches in the mouth part of the body. Acne-like warts in the groin area also starts showing up. How can you prevent it? Having sexual intimacy with only one person is the best cure for this, to avoid these kind of diseases. We need to avoid prostitution, homosexuality in any case. The patient should take medical treatment and should maintain the personal hygiene. The next disease is gonorrhea. It's a sexually transmitted disease that often involves urethra, vagina or penis, cervix, anus and throat. The bacteria responsible for it is gonococcus bacterium. Neisseria gonorrhoeae is the causative organism. Syphilis, the causative organism is Trypanonema palladium. It's a long corkscrew bacteria. The mode of spread is when you develop sexual contact with the infected person. Symptoms of the disease occur in about 10 to 90 days after contraction, but generally noticed in 3 to 4 weeks after getting infected with the bacteria. Symptoms of syphilis always occurs in several stages. The common symptoms of syphilis include fever and warts on the skin, sores on the skin, in the throat and urogenital areas, especially vagina or penis, anus, rectum and mouth. Their rashes are also visible on hands, feet and palms and white patches in the mouth. Again, how do you prevent it? You need to have sexual intimacy with only one person, avoid prostitution and homosexuality, and we need to maintain personal hygiene. The next disease is gonorrhea. It's a sexual transmitted disease that often involves urethra, vagina, penis, cervix, anus and throat. Its bacteria is Neisseria gonorrhoeae, is the causative organism. Multiple sex partners increases the risk of spreading it. Now the symptoms are inflammation of mucous membrane in the urogenital tract, rectal discomfort starts, pain in the joints, rashes on palms, mild sore throat, and in females it may even cause sterility. How do you prevent it? Having sexual contact with only one person and avoiding again prostitution and homosexuality types of things. One of the burning concern and disease or what burning problem that our society is facing is drug abuse. A drug is a chemical substance that changes the way out your body, way of working and mind work. Drug abuse occurs when drugs are taken without medical supervision, especially when they are taken in an amount that enhances your strength, frequency or the manner in which that damages the physical and mental functioning of the individual. When certain chemicals that have no medical use or benefits are taken, such as sniffing glue or solvents, drug abuse leads to a number of short-term and long-term effects that are detrimental to your health. Constant and excessive use of drugs over a long period of time can cause both physical and mental damage and illness. This includes failure in academic studies, employment and interpersonal relationships, financial ruin, increased risk of contracting STIs and increased risk of being involved in vehicular accidents. It damages not only your body but also your social skills, social relationship that you face in your society, that with which you interact in your society. Addicts stop thinking of everything in life except when and how they will get their next drug dose. They can do anything for this dose, including committing crimes such as theft and in certain, they can even murder. So it's a very dreadful disease. So learners, I think this session, interactive session, when we discussed about certain types of acquired diseases, communicable disease as well as non-communicable diseases, how many diseases are being caused by bacteria, by helminthes, by protozoans, by virus. Then we discussed so many diseases which are congenital disease as well as diseases which are non-communicable. I hope this session would be quite beneficial to you and you would be able to understand it very well. Thank you.